CTG Podcast, indeed.
Tutaja.
Tutaja. Welcome. So, anyway. Hello, fellow Cravers, and welcome to the CTG Podcast for Wednesday, the 22nd of June. It is episode 99. We are one away from 100. Yes. Ooh. How does that make you feel, Cajr?
Zero.
Hold.
Hold.
No, Shimmy. I was there day one.
Day one, yeah.
I wasn't, so I'm only half as old.
When did you... You was around about 34, episode 3040, weren't you?
So what?
Around about episode 3040, you started.
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah.
I think it was. I didn't keep going. I was enjoying myself too much to...
Yeah, we're enjoying ourselves. That's the thing, is actually this 100 episodes have gone quite quick so far, hasn't it?
Have they?
It has.
Yeah, it feels like it's gone quite quick.
Fucking hell, not yeah. For me.
Well, it's because you're always asleep.
Once.
If people haven't...
You spoke about Nintendo. That proves it.
If people haven't noticed, you're joined this week by me, GDW, Cajr, and Shimmy. So, hi.
Hi.
So, we're a week off from E3. E3 is over and done with. Now I've actually got you both here. What did you guys think of E3 yourselves?
Underwhelmed.
You covered Microsoft, didn't you,
Cajr? I did Microsoft, which was shocking as shit for Microsoft.
It's on two consoles! One of them's not even... It's only screenshots of it.
Oh, fucking annoyed now. Fuck out me.
What about you, Shimmy? You was, what was you? Was you preferred? No, I was preferred.
I was EA, so...
I was EA. Oh, yeah, yours was worse.
I was just the same twaddle, yeah. And then I had to watch a load of people who don't play games for, like, 12 hours.
At least you had Jose Mourinho on your...
Yeah, Jose Mourinho. I had Snoop Dogg getting stoned.
That was after the show.
So then, no, it was still part of what I was watching.
Yeah. So in other words, a normal EA conference.
Normal EA conference. Yeah.
A sports star it, but... and some rapper. There we go. But I don't know. I actually enjoyed it. We did get some good announcements come from it.
What?
Well,
on the whole, there were some good ones. Yeah, there were
some good ones. We found out about Resident Evil 7 is actually coming out. They've actually given us a bit more information about it. The game is going to be in first person, which we saw. And it's going to be starring a new protagonist. And more importantly, the demo that has come out that you can download on your PlayStation at the moment.
Yeah.
The character that you play in that... is not actually in the game, and none of that is actually in the game. So they are pretty much doing a PT on us.
All right, personal trainer. No way.
Yeah, they're doing a personal trainer on us. So,
from what I gathered, though, about that game, is I've seen a few things. It's basically, effectively, it's made for VR.
Yeah.
Still use control and everything, but that's what it's aiming towards, the VR market.
But then again, are you happy that they've sort of gone down, by the looks of things... gone back down the older route where they are trying to scare you again, like they did with the
original.
The thing is, a lot of people complained because the game was going too much towards action than horror, and now they've seemed to, which is weird, they've gone the complete opposite with 7. Now you're going straight to horror, and by the looks of things, not that much action. Are you happy that they're doing that? I think that's what we've all been asking for.
I've never been a Resident Evil fan, really. I enjoy watching it, but I've never enjoyed playing it, so I'm not really bothered. But I am happy it's gone to the more survival-y side, because it does get a bit stupid, and the way that the new character is involved, it got a bit too messy at the end. I think that's what the problem with Resident Evil 6 was. It was just a bit of a hodgepodge of like these superhero-y type people that have been infected with the virus and have cool powers, and there was too many stories going on. I think it was good when it was at its core, when it was more like a haunted house with zombies.
Yeah.
And then it expanded, obviously, because the virus expanded, but it was better to be in a small story than on a bigger scale.
Mm. Well, it's one of those games that has pretty much made me think of wanting to get a VR headset. The thing is, there wasn't that much VR... At the beginning of the E3 conferences, there wasn't that much VR stuff announced. I think we had Bethesda who came out and told us that they're going to be doing Fallout 4 and Doom in VR. And then, yeah, Doom as well.
Doom.
Yeah, Doom, yeah. And then we had Square Enix, who's shown off two new IPs, which are going to be VR-focused. One of them with an eagle. But then when Sony came...
That looked quite good.
That looks quite good, yeah. But it's just... I still find it quite weird, in a way. Because it's one of those games... Okay, I expect it from Ubisoft. Because it's one of those weird games where you think, right, so I'm an eagle? Yeah, you're an eagle. And there's no humanity left. Yeah. So what are we doing? You're playing Capture the Flag with a rabbit. Oh, okay.
And somehow it manages to get to the top of the Eiffel Tower.
Yeah. That makes perfect sense. Thank
you. It's in the lift.
To me, it looks like a decent game. What made me go out and buy VR, a VR headset, I'll say that right now. But it's one of those, it's trying to show you different ways of using it. You've got the horror side, they're going to be more and more thing. And then you, obviously, Bethesda's doing Doom and 360, went in the RPG route. It's like, Ubisoft said, you know what, this is just a nice, simple game. You can just look around and...
Well, the thing is what you expect from the start of VR anyway. It's games where they want to try and show that, guess what, you're actually in this environment now. If you look behind you, guess what, you can see what is actually behind your character. And that is what these games are doing at the moment.
That's the whole idea of it, isn't it?
Yeah.
The developers are still learning themselves. So first couple of years, the games won't be top-notch. It'll be... Like the Eagles game, I forgot what it's called.
But we know what we're on about. The Eagle Capture the Flag with Rabbits game. That's what I'm going with.
There will be games like that because they're still testing what they can do.
But I think Sony's got a stronger lineup at the moment. Because, like I said, they've got Resident Evil 7, which is coming out. Also, they've got the new Psychonauts game, which is designed for VR. I've seen it actually being played, and it looks actually really good. And the thing is, this is what I expect from Sony. They've got these game studios, they've got these great connection with game developers, that I expect them to have the better games coming for their system.
Yeah.
But when's that coming out? That's coming out October, isn't it?
Yeah, October.
Yeah, and Resident Evil doesn't come out until January anyway. So, and I think the price is about £350 for the PlayStation VR when that comes out. So it's still one of the cheaper ones that are coming, that's out there, with Vive still being the most expensive.
I could get another two monitors from my computer for that price.
Didn't we have this conference? This feels very deja vu-ish.
Did we have this conversation already?
I think you said the exact same quote.
I didn't say that. But I could do. I could have four monitors then.
Yeah. But I don't know. I think I do want to play with it. I do want to have a go of the PlayStation VR whenever I get a chance. Because it was at EGX last year. And unfortunately, because you had to register to have a go of it, I never actually got a chance. I've shown you... headset that I haven't had a go of, but is the because I haven't had a go of it, it's the one I want the most.
You've been sad, those feels, want to reach out and
I want to play the VR, but it's like at the same time I want to hold back from it because I feel like it's
sounds like you want to make love to your cousin sort of thing. It's like you want to hold back, but want it so bad.
It feels like it feels wrong, but feel no.
just move on now.
Yeah, let's move away from that quick.
It feels so wrong, but yeah, it feels so right. I do it all the time. I'm not scared. I am some chicken.
I bet
nugget.
Your cousin is though.
Only
whenever you turn around to his house.
Anyway, let's move away from that. So, like I said, with VR, it's going to be interesting to see where it comes out, especially when PlayStation comes through. Because I feel like if anyone at the moment is going to win, it is PlayStation, because they've got the backing of the games. I think we've said this many times. A console is more successful when they've got the backing of the games behind them.
Yeah.
For example,
I don't think the Five's actually aiming towards the console market, so...
Well, they're not aiming for the console markets, but they've still
got... Is that
got...
the one where you've got to actually buy a PC to run it?
Yeah, that's the same with Oculus. Both Oculus... No, that's the thing with Oculus
with
and
bundle
VR.
With a PC, doesn't it?
You can get a bundle with a PC. Right. I think it's around about £1,000 or something like that. Because they'll have a PC which is suited for VR. But then again, a lot of the newer graphics cards that are coming out, they already are VR ready, aren't they? Especially the Nvidia cards that have come out. But yeah, with the PlayStation, you don't have that problem. So because it runs with the PS4, that is what it's doing. I think it's got a central hub with it, and then you've got to run with the PS4. And I think the only extra thing that you would probably have to buy is the PlayStation camera, just so that it can be picked up. I think this is what a lot of people are more annoyed about, is because it's going to be more focused towards consoles than PC, like the Vive and the Oculus Rift are. But then, if you're having the same experience with it, what's the problem? Okay, yeah, it might not be as graphically improved until Neo comes out, but it's the feel of the gameplay of it. You still will be immersed into the game.
Immersion to be the best thing, yeah.
Yeah, that's the thing. It's the immersion into it, which... Yeah, the thing is, that's with the Vive and the Oculus. Like I said, I've had a go of both of them. I always think at the moment, between the Oculus and the Vive, what I've had a go of, the Oculus is better. Because of the immersion of it. But then again, it could be what game you're playing. I ended up playing the Vive. I ended up playing Elite Dangerous.
Hmm.
And no offense, I'm not a fan of those kind of games. With the Vive, on the other hand, I was strapped to a what looks like a... You know, like the wheel things that you take crates into?
Sack barrow.
A what?
Sack barrow.
Yeah, something like that. Yeah, you're basically on one of those, and you're going into, like, this laboratory.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, you can't move around the area, but you can easily move your head, and you're looking around. But it felt so immersive, and it...
Did it feel like you were the guy strapped to it?
Exactly, yeah. The thing is, have any of you two had a go of VR yet? But I'm guessing you would want to have a go of it.
Yeah, I'd have a go, yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
Cajr, he's lying.
Yeah, oh, cool, Cajr. No, seriously, if I offered you...
Well, I missed that. What did you say?
Yeah, you would want to have a go of it as well, wouldn't you?
No.
Why?
Of course you would. You got to have a go. Doesn't mean you want to buy one.
So if I said that the PlayStation VR was in your city at that time, and you could actually go and play it, would you turn it down?
Yes.
No, he wouldn't.
I would, seriously.
Just a prank, bro. Come on.
Why would you turn it down?
I don't like the thought of just. Playing a game.
Is it scaring you?
No, to me, your game's just a controller TV. I can see what's happening out the window. I can see if somebody's coming up next to me.
Yeah.
I just don't like, you know, it's hard to put a finger on, but it just doesn't interest me.
I feel like it's one of those things that if we ever have an office and we somehow have got one of the VR headsets, you're the person who's worried that one of us are going to hit you while you're wearing it.
No, because if you hit me, I will hit back.
No, but...
10 times as hard.
The problem is, knowing our attitude, what we would be like, we would do that. Do you know who I think would be the first person to do it? That guy over there.
I don't know, I said heaven with myself, but...
I would think Shimmy.
Me?
Yeah.
But, like I say, it just doesn't interest me one bit. It's... Mm. I'm sure there'll be some great games come out for it.
Yeah.
But, no, just give me a control and a TV.
The thing is, like I said, I can't wait to see what happens, but I do want it. but I don't want to buy it straight away.
Yeah, see what happens.
Yeah. Well, I think at this stage at the moment, I think I won't be able to buy it straight away because I've heard that they've already, with the PlayStation VR, they've already pretty much, the pre-orders are...
surpassed the stock.
Yeah. That's interesting. Of GTA 5 first person mode in VR.
That would be cool.
No. I just thinking of it, I don't like the idea. Because the last thing I want to feel is want to see is myself getting run over by Cajr.
That's the first thing and only thing I want to see is you getting run over by Cajr.
VR Minecraft, you can see yourself burn from my lava.
Talking about Minecraft, we actually have got a video that we're probably going to be doing in the next couple of weeks because there's been an update on the consoles this week.
Battles is now available.
Yeah,
but that's downloadable. It's downloadable content.
No. It is free.
Then why is it asking for a season pass and it's charging?
Because it's also... What it is, you've got Minecraft normal. You get free maps in this mini... game
free, that's 33.
You know,
or is it six?
You get free maps for free, with the update which is coming out, but you can also buy free extra maps, which is available in the game as well. So, right. Everyone can play it, it is available for everyone who has got Minecraft, and I think it is on Xbox One, PS4, and the Wii U at this time.
When did that happen?
They had it December.
Not that long ago.
Yeah, so they've just had Minecraft themselves. So they've just caught up with us. So you've got the free maps. I've not had a go of it yet, unfortunately, because I've not gathered enough people. But it seems that you can actually play with your friends, of course, and have private lobbies, but there is also public lobbies available as well if you just want to play with random people. Which, yeah. It's nice to see because, like I said, PC's had this kind of mode, these kind of modes for a while, haven't they, Shimmy?
Yeah, that's what drawn me to PC.
What, Minecraft battles?
Oh, but that sort of whole... focusing on that sort of things and the community and multiplayer and
yes,
so that's what brought me to that as opposed to consoles, and consoles are getting the taste and catching up now, so as that is the main draw of PC for me, you know, when consoles catching up, everything's on a level playing field, it might take me back there. And
well, the thing is, I've got a feeling with consoles they're going to be catching up a lot quicker now, especially with the Minecraft Realms coming sometime next year. Because they would have to try and catch up with PC, won't they? If they're going to be on the same playing level field.
Mojang
or Microsoft is owned by Microsoft. Therefore, yes. Microsoft's going to want the best possible Minecraft, especially on the Xbox One.
Yes. Mm. And the thing is, if they got one of the best possible Minecraft on the Xbox One, they've also got to pull it for the PS4 and the Wii U because of what agreement they had with Mojang. The thing is, they're not allowed to, especially when it comes to updates to the gameplay itself. They can't. They've got.
Gee,
to
turn your phone off.
Why?
Every time I see it, it's bloody rotating.
I'm sorry, I can't turn it off because that's my giving me the information what we're supposed to be talking about.
What happened to your pen and paper?
I can't find it, okay?
That's about 3 weeks.
I know.
Yeah, but I mean, the thing is, though, like, this is the reason why, like, the Nintendo Wii has always held itself back graphically and focused on family fun and children's entertainment as well. Consoles have pushed graphics and that sort of stuff, and then the computers have stayed the way. If everything gets to the level playing field, then... I think you need the cheaper consoles to be cheaper and consoles to be easy accessible. When you start thinking of interchangeable parts and extra costs and more complexity, then it takes that reason why people play console in the first place. It's just plug in and play and get on with it.
Yeah, well, my question here is, do you think ever, with PC and console, do you think we'll ever have them at a level playing field? The thing is it's like, if you look at consoles now, the consoles that have come out, they were great. They were pretty much at the same level with PC when they came out. But now it's been 3 years, and we've got some new graphics cards that are coming out. PCs are more powerful than consoles, to a point that they're now also going to be bringing out their 0.5s of this generation of consoles, known as Project Scorpio and Project Neo.
Mm.
So I never see them going to be at level playing field. Even when they said that consoles are going to be, we're going to be having it so that you can do interchangeable bits. Console player gamers are not going to want that.
No,
if they want that, they would get a PC.
Yeah.
It's simple enough that if you want to do that kind of stuff, you would get yourself a PC because it'll be cheaper for you to do that.
Yeah, if consoles are trying to become a PC, then there will be no consoles, and you might as well just have a PC. PCs are diverse and more complex than a console, and it's...
I think that's
just more things to go wrong as well on a console, isn't there? You just switch it on and off you go.
I think that's why, in my opinion, I prefer a console, is because of the simplicity. You switch it on, you play. That's what you do. You buy the box, you plug it in, and then you go and play. That's it. And that'll be all right. That'll be good enough for at least about 5, 6, 7 years there. PC, on the other hand, it's a lot more complicated. You've got to think, right, you need this, you need this, you need this, you need this. Oh, you haven't got that? Oh, too bad, you can't play this game. Or you can play this game, but it won't be as good as this guy over here who's got this a bit better. You don't want that if you're a console gamer.
No.
A PC gamer, I completely understand. That's what you want because that's what you've brought into.
Mm.
Console gamer hasn't. They just want a console that you can play. Simple.
Yeah, it's simple games, simple playing, and everyone gets happy. You come home from work, you just put it on, you play your Call of Duties or whatever, and then, you know.
Do you think the problem for consoles is the advancements in technology are going too fast for them now?
Yes. But then...
They're getting outdated much more quickly.
Yeah, I would say that is the problem, because I think, look at... Like I said, we're already on about the 0.5 consoles, aren't we? And it's by the time the Xbox One's Project Scorpio comes out, it will be, is it the fourth year of the Xbox One?
Come on.
Yeah. So I've got a feeling that's when Project Neo, when that comes out, is going to be coming out around about the same time. Which, yeah, it makes sense. 4 years into the lifespan of this generation is usually around about that time we do get the upgraded version of the consoles. It happened last generation, it happened the generation before that. But I think it's at a point now where people are looking at this and saying, right, you need to have these kind of things with this. Like, compared to last year, it was, it's the same stuff, but now it's in a smaller box. This time it's, no, these are now more upgraded things that are in here. And it's the same size box. But don't worry, you can still play your games on the other system. I think, okay, thanks, I guess. But then, have they brought out these Project Scorpio and Neo, not because of the upgraded graphics side of it, but for the fact of VR? Have they made these consoles ready for that?
Probably.
Because
I would suspect so. Yeah, I think they feel like they have to do it to.
Well, the thing
not is, have things go tits up and overheat and explode.
Exactly. The thing is, we know that the PlayStation 4 at the moment, which is out now, we know that we've been told that the VR headset, which is coming out at the end of this year, is suitable for it. But we've also been told this new one, which is going to be coming out, we don't know when. We'll probably get told at the PlayStation Experience at the end of the year again, whenever this is coming out. It's supposed to be running better. But then, yeah, that's what you expect with this. Well, with Microsoft, on the other hand, they've not mentioned anything about VR. And there's been rumours going around so often now that they are going to be jumping into the VR market. The fact that I think a lot of people are saying that they're striking a deal with the Vive. It's either the Vive, I think if anything, it's going to be Vive or Rift, isn't it? The thing is, Microsoft is not going to be making their own VR headset, especially when they've got the HoloLens, which suddenly seems like it's gone a lot, it's gone quiet lately.
Yeah, I've not heard anything for a while.
No, we haven't, yeah. I think they've looked at it thinking, yeah, they don't really want artificial reality, do they? They want that. They want the VR stuff, don't they?
Is it Deus Ex? No.
Yeah, no, no, they don't. They want VR. But they could have a fake screen on the screen, on the wall. I think they actually do want a screen on the wall because they don't really want to seem like they're wearing these weird little goggles that look like Google Glass and looks like that they're watching the game where no one else can see it.
Yeah, it's
crazy. It's all right for VR because people understand because they can watch what they're looking at on a PC. Artificial reality, not as much.
I think once the VR's out, the hype dies down a bit and people have decided if it is a gimmick or it is going to stay, then they would probably come back out. I mean, if people do start saying there's problems, I can't play on it, it gets me motion sickness, and next thing you know, a couple of months later, it goes in the drawer and never to be played with again. And they'll probably go for the jugular.
Yeah, well, the thing is, it's going to cause motion sickness. I think this is the good thing about Oculus Rift. They have been working on it now for many years, haven't they? I think, how long has Doc had his Oculus Rift himself?
2 years, I think, is it?
Yeah. And they have improved it over. It's not the fact of the actual headset itself. It's also how the games work. I think they've said that there's one thing that a lot of people have been... A lot of games have noticed that they've got to have a sort of like a nose figure in the game, because that is the point of stopping people from feeling nauseous, because they've got a focus point. That's the point. If you look now, you can just see your nose when you're looking straight ahead.
Motion sickness is also your eyes can see you moving, but you can't.
Yeah.
You can't. Your body's not moving. So when you're running about somewhere, I remember on the PlayStation, it was an Aliens game.
Yeah.
That was first person, and you'd run around shooting, and that game used to, play it for 10 minutes.
Because of the blood as well,
afterwards. And it was like, oh my God, that's horrible. And that was just the way it moved, and like just the draw of the screen and the blur, and it was just awful. Yeah. Made you feel ill. So there is ways around it, like you said, with the nose.
But like I said, I think it's mainly more on the actual developers of the game with that. And see how they do with that. I do agree also that the people behind the actual hardware should do something about it as well. But they can only do so much. It's mainly the software that needs to be developed for it. It's what you're actually seeing, not what you're feeling half the time. So, anyway, let's move away from VR because we have actually spoken a lot about it so far this podcast. And, I'm looking at what we've got here. Oh yeah, we already know about Batman in VR. I said we'd not talk about more VR. Oh yeah, we might as well talk about this. And I know you're not going to like me for this, but we are going to be talking a little bit of Nintendo here. Pokemon Go. Pokemon Go, we've now got a release. It's coming out next month.
Yes.
What do you guys think of it?
I'll give it a go.
Yeah, well, it's going to be free. The actual app for it. And they've also said that the Go Plus, which is the little symbol thing that you can have, that's like a Bluetooth to your phone or anything, that kind of tells you, oh, there's a Pokemon around here. It's going to be around about, it says around about $35 here, so I'm expecting £30 at the most for us.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not going to buy that.
I wouldn't pay £30 for a brooch that glows in the dark, no.
The thing is, though,
especially
you've got people walking around with their phones like that around town.
Yeah, I think that's the point of it, yeah.
Yeah, but how stupid are you going to look?
Not that stupid if everyone's doing it. Yeah.
Exactly, if everyone's doing it.
And then when you're if you're the only one, you're like, oh, there's a Pokemon there. Fucking get it.
You say that. But do you know what I actually want to do? I want to do that and see how many Pokemon are in my room. I turn around. Oh, it's
just gonna be. I'm just gonna be in the Caterpie area.
You'll just have a Ghastly corner.
I've got a Ghastly in the corner. I've got a Grime in there. The bin. I've got Trubbish.
there's a Jinx in your shower.
And there's a Slowpoke in my bed.
There's Slowpoke. Jesus Christ.
I'd like to point out, I've noticed more about Pokemon because I've been playing the trading card game again.
There's an Ekans in your trousers.
No, mate, that's an Arbok. Sorry.
In your dreams.
An Arbok. Jesus Christ. Sank to new lows.
Yeah, I know.
More like a Diglett, innit?
Well, yeah,
a Diglett. Hopefully it's not a dog trio.
Yeah, that's roaring. although the Pokemon Go will come in at £35, the actual game will be free when it launches next month on both iOS and Android devices. So it's going to be available for everybody, which I expect it to be. Because you can't just say, oh wait, no, it's not available for Windows phones. I just thought about that. Do they still make Windows phones?
Don't think they do.
No. I haven't heard anything. I think now they just focus on the Xbox app.
Still do the software, is there not?
I don't know. I don't know anyone
who has
a Windows phone.
They probably still support the old Windows phones. Don't make ones.
I know a friend of mine's got a Windows OS. It's Nokia, I think.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I think that's who they partnered up with, weren't it? Nokia.
But, they're not actually giving us the full release date of when it's coming. All we know is that Pokemon Go is going to be coming out in July. So, I know what I'll be playing next month. And yes, I will. No, I won't be playing in the streets.
Well, do you have to battle and trade with people who you're next to then?
Right, at the moment they've actually mentioned about the trading system. It is going to be coming to the app, but it will not be available from launch. Battle is, I don't know, it's one of those weird things. All they've shown us at the moment is you actually fighting wild Pokemon and catching wild Pokemon. There is going to be microtransactions in this game as well. And I've got a feeling we already know how the microtransactions are going to work.
Yeah.
Pokeballs.
Yes. Pay $79.99, you get a Master Ball.
Instant catch on a Mewtwo that you have to go all the way to Japan for one special day for.
You know there's people who are going to do that, mate.
See you there.
Let's all go, yes, we're all going
to
Japan.
The thing is, other than battling, what can you actually do with the Pokemon?
Tamagotchi. It's our style.
Are you limited to how many you can have?
Yeah, I'm going to guess you can carry only 6.
No, I'm getting, but you can catch them all.
You can catch them all, yeah, but you can only
carry
6. How
do you make
6?
Them evolve? If you...
Well, how you normally
which,
do
which
battle.
Pokemon, which Pokemon can you catch?
Isn't it just the original 150 to begin with?
They haven't really said. I think we've seen some screenshots that have got... What we've seen with screenshots is, the only things that we've seen with screenshots is the original 150 at the moment. But you never know. I think it's going to be one of those things that it'll evolve over time. And I know what I said. I've got a feeling when things like Pokemon Sun and Moon come out, we're going to see more of other Pokemon show up. You got to remember, in the end, they've got to get all these Pokemon and do them in 3D as well. Because that is what the game is. The game's the 3D Pokemon in AR. Because it used to... They did this with Google Maps, didn't they, at one point?
Yeah, that's what started it all.
Yeah.
But the thing is, though, I think they've actually openly said, you're going to have to leave your neighbourhood so you catch them all. Now, if you're in a neighbourhood and you've got just shit Pokemon everywhere, you're going to be so pissed off...
Yeah, you go outside and, oh my fucking god, they're all cappies.
Like, I'm going to have to go to Nottingham to catch
Lugia.
A Diglett.
Then I'm going to have to go all the way to Newcastle. Like Blackburn and Preston and all those places around there and catch a Trubbish.
Oh. Then you go all the way to near Manchester area to go and catch a Coffin.
Yeah. I don't live in Manchester, so it's okay.
Cheshire you live in, don't it?
Yeah.
Oh, and then you go to Essex for a Jinx. And then you realise it wasn't actually part of the game.
Yeah, and you realise you've got an STD instead.
Got to catch them all. Oh, I'm sorry. God. This is one of the worst punning episodes we've ever done. Oh, God. But, yeah, like I said, coming out next month. When we find out an actual date, it'll probably be out. So, it's going to be one of those that is just going to show up on the App Store, isn't it?
Yeah.
So, I'm looking forward to it. I'm definitely going to download it when it comes out because I do want to have a go of it. Ever since I've heard about it, it's one of those games that I've been wanting to have a go of. So, yeah, good luck to coming with that.
Oh, hopefully there'll be no coming with it.
Sorry. I didn't mean that. Let's talk... The thing is, I'm going to point out now, there isn't... Because it was E3 last week, news is a bit dry this week, which I've noticed.
Dry like your sense of humour.
Oh. My sense of humour is not that dry.
I just imagine a girlfriend's underwear.
That was savage.
Oh, wow. Oh, Doom 2... What the hell? Doom 2 just got a Seinfeld mode. What the hell's that?
Oh,
Seinfeld.
Have you ever played id Software's classic first-person shooter Doom and found something strangely familiar in its righteous MIDI bass rifts? Perhaps you were taken back to the beloved sitcom Seinfeld. No, because I never watched it. I'm too young for that. I don't know.
You can go to the set and kill everyone. Even not around the house. Basically.
Some way of which someone's just done a mod of Seinfeld.
Yep.
Wow, these are really struggling. Oh, okay, there's a story that we can talk about. Right, Criterion Games. Now, we've been hearing a lot lately that they've been trying to make a new extreme sports game, haven't they? Yep. I think it was announced, was it last year? Not last year, 2014's E3, that they were making the game for Microsoft that was based more on extreme sports and that lot.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we've been given news today that Burnout has dropped its Beyond Cars game to work on Star Wars instead. Why?
I hate it when they drop games.
I hate it more because they're dropping it to do more Star Wars.
Well, there's quite a few, from sounds of it, there's a few Star Wars games in the works.
Yes, that's not good.
Jumping on the bandwagon, aren't they, for all the...
That's
films that are coming out.
Do that, join Star Wars bandwagon. There we go.
Bandwagon strikes back.
Yeah. The thing is, how many game studios do we now know of which is working on a Star Wars or have already started work? Have already released a Star Wars game in this past couple of years now. It's just I'm not complaining that there's Star Wars games. I know that there's a market for them, especially with the movies that are coming out again. But there is just too much at the moment. It feels like EA are using all their studios to make Star Wars games now. Who?
Yeah.
Why?
Too many.
Yeah. It's like, what we had, we've got Battlefront at the moment, haven't we? We've got the one that Visceral's working on. We've got the one that... Respawn's working on now. We've got one that Criterion's working on. We've got the mobile game. I'm thinking...
It's a case of the striking while the iron's hot. Star Wars is big at the moment. They're going to capitalise.
Yeah, but
it's just same business sense.
But I'm more worried that they're going to... The thing is, we've seen this with many games genres over the time that we've been playing games. I think one of the biggest examples, look at music games. There was a huge craze at the beginning of the noughties, weren't they? Where you had things like Rock Band and Guitar Hero coming out. And because they kept on bringing out more and more and more as quickly as possible, it died because it was oversaturated.
Yeah, but your Rock Band and your Guitar Hero and all that, from one game to the next, though, pretty much the same game. It was exactly the same game, just different songs. Whereas you can have so many different kind of Star Wars games.
Like what?
Well, yeah,
you could have a racing pod racer.
What do you think? That's what Criterion's going to be working on, pod racer version.
You could have one set in space battles, Starfighter again. You know, there's all sorts. You could have one based on the movies. You could have one based way back, like the Knights of the Old Republic.
Yeah.
You have one set between the original trilogy and the prequel trilogy.
Yeah, so according to this, Criterion is currently co-developing the Star Wars Battlefront X-Wing VR mission with DICE for PlayStation VR. The title will be free for everyone who owns Star Wars Battlefront on the PS4, which I think we do. I think that's where we ended up playing it on, yeah. Criterion has also is also experimenting with new intellectual property, according to GameSpot report. I think it's more annoying because, like I said, this Beyond Cars, which was going to be coming out, it was pretty much going to be some sort of successor to the Burnout franchise. So it was pretty much going to be Burnout with other vehicles. And I think that's what a lot of people have been wanting, especially from Criterion, since we've had Burnout Paradise, that we've been wanting another version of this game. And when they said, oh yeah, we're working on something with other vehicles, a lot of people are excited about it because it's a great series.
Mm-hmm.
And now they've just, by the feelings of it, they've just completely dropped it. I think we've not even been given our Burnout Paradise on the Xbox One as backwards compatible yet. Which is, that's irritating me. We just need that. Please.
That's sad.
They must have looked at the game they were making. You must know that it might not be up to a good standard. And just thought, you know what? I have to shelve it or get rid of it completely and focus on something else. Maybe that's what it were. Maybe it was... I mean, we don't know what's happened behind closed doors.
Yeah, it could be that the game was absolutely shit. I think... Didn't we have the same experience with other games that have been canned as well? I think... Well, like, for example, Overwatch. Weren't that from... Is it Titan? Most of the assets for Overwatch that have come out from Blizzard.
I don't know.
Yeah. Well, Blizzard was already working on the game, which ended up getting canned, and a lot of people were unhappy with it, unhappy that they ended up canning it. But their main excuse that they said... main reason they said that they canned it was that it was boring. Which, okay, yeah, perfect sense. The thing is, I wish that... Criterion would come out and just tell us why they've decided to can this. And if it is because they're going to be working on the Star Wars thing, I'm not going to be happy with it. And I'm going to guess there's going to be a lot of people who are not going to be happy with that. The thing is, it's like, we don't need another studio working on Star Wars. We've got enough studios working on Star Wars now. We know that we've got about 3 or 4 games coming out in the next couple of years. Of Star Wars, and I think that's all right. We're happy with that.
You think Star Wars will just stay with the hype and then die down, or do you reckon they're going to try and make Battlefront the next Call of Duty or Battlefield?
I personally want it to die down. For the fact that, especially
you're not a Star Wars fan.
It's not that. It's like, for example, Star Wars Battlefront, which came out last year. It wasn't that good, according to... It was a good game.
Not enough maps and not enough things, yeah.
Yeah, there wasn't enough there for it to actually show how much... Especially when you had things like, for example, Battlefield and Call of Duty. They were better than Battlefront. And I think it was more because a lot of people just looked at it and thought, you know what you've done here? You've got Battlefield and you've put Star Wars on the front of it.
Yep.
Okay, yeah, I guess that's going to be selling, but you are just selling it because you've slapped a giant Star Wars sticker on it.
It did lose the essence of the original Battlefront.
Exactly, yeah. A lot of people got upset because of that. And I think I'm upsetting Ryan at the moment. Sorry. Battlefront was awesome sauce, yeah.
See how he says Battlefront was awesome sauce, and that is awesome sauce.
But you know what I mean. It's like, yeah, I'm... I'm looking forward to see what they do bring out with it, because I think I would like to see like a stealthy version of Star Wars. That would be quite fun to have. I think that's what 1313 was supposed to be, wasn't it? Until that ended up getting canned.
I think that got canned because it got sold to Disney, didn't it? And they wanted to.
Yeah,
that's,
that was the main reason that got canned, was because the sale. Yeah,
but the
to
thing
Disney.
The thing is about the Star Wars universe is you can do absolutely anything, and anything is possible in that universe.
Yeah, but at the same time, do you feel like if these things that they are making, would they be able to sell if it didn't have the Star Wars logo on it? Do you think Battlefront, the Battlefront that we got in December, if it wasn't Battlefront and it was its own IP, do you think it would have done well? Or do you think it only did well because it had Star Wars on it?
Star Wars on it.
Yeah, the Star Wars name sold, but so does the Call of Duty name sell for Call of Duty.
Yeah, but brand recognition.
That's why Overwatch is selling, because it's made by Blizzard.
Yes, I agree. But then again, at the same time, Overwatch is still a really good game. Even if it was on its own.
You could say, I mean, I've not played it, I don't know.
But it's like when you're saying things like Call of Duty, you got to remember in the end, The thing is, they earn their popularity through gaming. These things that they're making through Star Wars, it's because it's a movie franchise, which has been put on the games. And we've seen this many times with games. It's like Battlefront. Okay, yeah, it didn't have anything to do with the latest movie that came out last year. But at the same time, I would have put that in the same category as a movie video game, which is a bad place to be put.
No. I mean, you can get... I mean, look at all the Spider-Man games.
Yeah. Now,
some of them have been quite good.
There were one or two, yeah.
The ones which weren't movie tie-ins.
But I'm guessing you're excited about the Insomniac one, which is coming out.
Quietly, yeah.
Yeah, same here.
But it's... it's like you're saying, it did it sell because it's Spider-Man? Because you could have the similar... Like the Edge of Time where you're in four different times. Could that work without speed Spider-Man?
Yeah, I would say it would work. Yeah.
Well, obviously, it'd have to be changed because of the Spider-Man powers and all that crap. Yeah. But
I don't really like comic books and superheroes and stuff. And one of my favourite ever most played PlayStation 1 games was a Spider-Man.
Yeah.
Which one? I remember which one it was. It was one where you used to have like canisters to reload your webs. And you swing around, your face at the last boss was facing Carnage, which is like the pink Venom looking.
It was probably the Amazing Spider-Man one.
Probably the first one. Yeah, it was that one. And spider sense was tingling, and you do the thing, and that was a really great game. It had great boss battles, the generic story, but it was just a really good, solid game. And I replayed that story mode about 10 times.
Well, the thing is, that's what I'm thinking when it comes to things like that. You're saying, like, Spider-Man, at the end, the actual gameplay where it came with most of the game, well, some of the games which we're on about with it, they're great games. And the thing is, when a game which has got a franchise pinned onto it and isn't that good of a game, or it feels like it's just a skin over another game, they do get ridiculed for it. And I think that's the same when it came to Battlefront. The thing is, it was Battlefield with the Star Wars skin over the top of it. And it wasn't like it was a new Battlefield. No, it was the Battlefield that came out a couple of years ago. It was Battlefield... That's what it was. It was Battlefield 4 with Star Wars on top of it. And yes, I agree, it sold. And I did play it, and we did have fun with it. But that's what it was. It sold because of that.
Yeah, it was like a mod, really. A reskin.
It was a reskin. So, and the thing is, like I said, it was a good game, but it wasn't a great game. And I think this is what I'm getting sick of, especially when coming from E3, coming from the EA Play side of it. There was a whole section just for Star Wars games, wasn't there? And they didn't even show us anything. They're shown us a bunch of people working on tablets. Island. That's what it was. It was basically it was just about a 5 minute video of people working in studios with 1 or 2 minutes of gameplay of games we don't even know or games that are already out.
Yeah, fair enough. I just say Ireland have beaten Italy 1-0.
Really?
Yeah, and Belgium beat Sweden 1-0.
So that means Italy... Well, Italy didn't need to win anyway. Anyway, yeah, we'll talk about that in a bit. Sorry.
Sorry,
that's football, sorry.
Just popped up.
Sorry. But, yeah, I think that's with me. I'm just getting sick of all these Star Wars games that are being announced now. And I think that's what I'm hating is people just looking and thinking, oh, it's the greatest thing ever, a new Star Wars game. No. I don't want that. EA, give us something new. And I think this is what's upset me most with this Criterion.
It's giving us Battlefield 1.
Yeah, fuck that. Yeah, that's not something new.
that is something we've been saying.
You got
need to go back
to
the old school.
That is the one FPS shooter I'm looking forward to.
I'm looking forward to too. Sorry. But no, I think this is what's upsetting me with this, is where we've got in studios who are now going straight to work on the Star Wars thing. When, especially when it feels like with the Criterion 1, they've dropped something that a lot of people have been wanting. And, yeah. Yeah, it's always good to have more, so you are right there, GD.
Yeah. It was good to have more Star Wars games.
No, it's more Star Wars.
No more Star Wars!
I don't know. More goals.
No, I'm happy that they are making some games, but look, don't put all your studios making Star Wars, because, for example, if, say, Rogue One comes out and it's shit, and then the second... What movie on now? Eight?
Eight.
Yeah, if Eight comes out and is one of the worst pieces of cinematic... crap that's ever come out of Hollywood, then
like Seven.
What? I ain't even seen Seven yet.
Neither have I. No. I'm not interested.
I have. I went on DVD.
The thing is, you know what I mean. If it turns out that is one of the worst things ever made, and
Star Wars will always have its fans.
Yeah, I know.
I'm sure if the Star Wars
like Call of Duty. Sorry,
if Star Wars fans can get through the prequel trilogy,
yeah,
especially the Phantom Menace, I'm sure they can go through
You got a point there, yeah. If it could get through the trilogy of crap, which was the early noughties of movies.
That's why they didn't make it. That's why they started from number four, because the first three are utter shite.
Yeah, no one's actually coming up. Right, I want to know Darth Vader's origin story.
Yeah, it's like...
You can't start at number four, then go back to number
one.
The
thing is, they didn't even have to tell us that. The only reason that we knew that the original Star Wars movie was number four was because they made three more movies that was a pre-sequel.
No, if you watch the original Star Wars, it actually says... It says episode four.
Does it?
Yes.
Then George Lucas is a dick.
Because it was that's why they made Lord of the Rings trilogy before they made the Hobbit films.
No, it did actually have the Hobbit license.
One minute. You do know that the Hobbit and Lord of the Rings are actually books. Star Wars wasn't a book.
Star Wars was a book.
Wait, no, it wasn't a book. It was a movie first.
Wasn't?
It was.
Book first.
No, it was a movie first.
Book first.
Lord of the Rings and the Hobbit was books first.
I hate to say this, but I agree with GD in this situation.
Yeah, Star Wars was a movie first.
But it must have been a book, it must have been a script.
Start with that, mate. No. Yeah, I know where you're going with that, but no. It was a script for a movie. You can't say that the Hobbit book was a script for the movie. I think the looking at the book here is something that you read when you was in secondary school. And look, right, the book is about this thing. How can we make three movies out of this? Had Hollywood managed.
Oh, well.
Right, so not the first time they made it, Cajr.
I'm reading something about that, whether it was a book or a movie first. Technically, it might have been a book.
No. No.
Oh, yeah.
Let's just.
Hang on. If it wasn't a book first, then why did they start with. How was the six to choose from, and they started from.
Because George Lucas wanted to be a dick about it.
I don't understand.
Yeah, but there was a book released before the first film.
Was there?
Yes.
Is that what the first, second, and third movies were? It was actually a book. And
let
it was
me,
actually
let
just
me
a
read
very
the, let me read the, let me read the excerpt. I'm here. Taking notes of the dates. Star Wars From the Adventures of Luke Skywalker is the original title of the novelization of the 1977 film Star Wars Episode IV, A New Hope.
Yep.
Credits to George Lucas, but was actually ghostwritten by Alan. It was first published on November 12, 1976.
Okay.
It was published before the film was actually released.
But then again, how long were they probably working on the original film?
Who knows, but right. Technically it was a book before it was a film.
Why start before then? I don't understand. Why didn't you just call them ones 1, 2, and 3?
Because then when you want to go backwards, he must have had a story, a timeline in his head
yeah.
at some point. And he thought, right, this is a trilogy.
But he also had Jar Jar Binks in his head.
Or he probably had...
Yeah, and look what happened there.
Yeah. Unless he actually had written 1, 2, and 3, and then 4 and said, yeah, you know what? Ignore those three because they're absolute shit. These should never be made. Let's just do 4, 5, and 6 and just carry on.
If I remember correctly, I could be wrong. I think the reason he started with number 4 is because it needed a lot less special effects because of all the places they were visiting. Back in 77, special effects weren't that great.
Oh, no, they weren't.
In comparison to... But then it's like, because of all the extra aliens and all that, I think he probably needed better special effects before he went to the thing. I could be wrong.
Well, wasn't Star Wars classed as a cinematic masterpiece when it first came out because of its effects at that time? And now you wouldn't even see indie movies using that.
It was set on like Tatooine, which is just desert, in space where it's just like green screen. And
Heavenly Sweat, if you mean some
dodgy jungle stuff.
Heavenly's asking, are we voting in or voting out? I know what she's going to put next. I'm voting out because I want out from the Star Wars movies. I'm sick of it. I'm not voting.
It's actually a 12-part story.
Oh, God, seriously?
It was cut down to 9 3-trilogy story. The first one was the rise and fall of Anakin War. The second was the rise of Luke Skywalker and the redemption of Anakin Skywalker. And the third trilogy was to be about the other Skywalker. So originally, the second trilogy was meant to be about Leia. But
I love that. I love that. So it's Anakin, it's Luke, and then it's the other Skywalker. We don't talk about that Skywalker.
His estranged twin brother.
Yeah. Hi guys, I got the Force. Look at me move this, move my mind. Star Wars. Anyway, let's move away from Star Wars because we actually spoke a lot. It's been a VR Star Wars episode. This week.
Episode 4.
Episode 99. So let's do a few quick updates that we've got here. The usual bits and pieces that we do at the end of things. Didi, have you moved rooms?
Yeah, he's now living next door to you.
I've been...
What's Texas,
how long have I been
again?
Up here now?
Months.
It's been months, yeah. Yeah, I can't decide. I'm undecided. Okay, fair enough. Anyway, let's just talk about the quick news updates, blah, 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 kind of stuff that we usually do at the end. So, updates. I can't spell at the moment. Updates, new releases. Boop. There we go. So, where do we start? Sony could be paying millions to PS3 owners after a 6-year legal dispute.
This, probably, I'm going to guess this is going to be about the hack, that big hack they had.
No. This isn't about the hack. This is about... the company has agreed to a potential settlement with the Linux-loving PS3 users. So the Sony promised that on PS3 you could have a different OS system added onto it with Linux, and then it never actually appeared on the system. So a lot of people have been complaining about it. And so Sony Entertainment America has agreed to a settlement that could see them compensating upwards of 10 million PlayStation 3 owners for the removal of Linux support from the console.
Oh.
So, I want some money. Oh, they said that Sony will pay the plaintiffs $55 upon proof of eligibility for the payout. So they're getting $55 each. But that is still a lot of money. Is that... That's 5.5 million.
Jesus Christ. No.
$550 million that they're going to be paying out because of this.
That's a lot of dollars.
Yeah. Just because they took away the ability to use Linux on a PS3. Well, thanks, Heavenly. I'm just reading what it says here. God of War director says the game was influenced by cancelled Star Wars TV show.
How?
I'm looking into it now. How the hell did you, God of War, Star Wars?
Maybe it's about Darth Vader looking after his little son.
It's the new God of War game that's coming out, simply called God of War. They say that the team wanted to focus on giving Kratos a second chance to change his ways, and one of the best ways to do that was to explore his role as a father.
Yep.
Yeah, that's what they said. The main reason they've made him a father in this new God of War that's coming out to show a sympathetic side of him. Which, yeah, it makes sense, because if you've played any of the other God of War games, he's basically just a mad killing machine killing anything that gets in his way.
Well, yeah, it's basically me.
What are the chances this kid's going to die very early in that game?
he's going to be the final boss.
Yeah. Yeah, he said, he's going to kill all the Nordic gods, and then he's just going to look down and say, there you go, son, I've done it for you.
Yeah, for being a bitch, knock me out.
He's
got a big beard in it as well to show his maturity.
No. don't say that. I have no idea how that's a cancelled Star Wars related. But yeah, sure. Mighty No. 9 had a rough launch day. Yeah, if people don't know, Mighty No. 9 is now out.
What's Mighty No. 9?
Mighty No. 9 is Mega Man. It's Mega Man not made by Capcom, but made by the original creator of Mega Man. I think it was kickstarted, wasn't it? A couple of years ago. And it's taken this long for the game to come out. So it's looking great for ukulele.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Got a ukulele.
Yeah, so, Twitch archives are still available for the 2-hour stream, and it's worth a watch. Translator Ben Judd hosted a discussion with people like lead designer KG Inafune and other producers and directors about the trials of Mighty No. 9's lengthy production. So how was it bad? On a somber look into the studio's troubled development process, it has run into several problems on the public scale for the past 3 years. And, I think everyone knows how bad the actual story behind Mighty No. 9 has become. Where the game was promised to be coming out a couple of years ago, and it's just come out now. And then there's now more stories coming out saying that the promised of... what's it called? DLC for Kickstarters, which isn't going to be coming out to them now as well. No. So they're failing to live up to their Kickstarter rewards as well.
Oh, is that the EU?
What?
Oh, is that the EU?
What's that got to do with the EU?
It's full of people full of shit.
Don't start bringing politics into this, mate.
It's just a one-liner. Let's move on with our lives.
Let's move on, yes. I think Ryan wants us to mention about Lego.
I've got some Lego at my nan's, some my daughter plays with.
I think they've been saying that there's some more Lego Dimension characters going to be coming out or something.
Isn't that it being cancelled along with the Disney Infinity? Or
No. Only Infinity's being cancelled, all right? And it's more annoying because they've shown some more characters that were being planned, including a Doctor Strange one.
Dr. Jones, calling Dr. Jones.
I just point out this is just our limit of what information's come out this week.
We're looking not doing your job properly, JD, are you?
I'm doing my job properly. It's not my fault that there's not much news coming out.
What news is on gravygame.com/news?
Well, we've got a couple of streams planned, I guess. So we've got Halo Reach coming out on Thursday, which me and Cajr were starting the series again. Is it Reach or ODST?
I need to install that, actually. Now you remind me.
Yep, thanks. I've got access to the Alpha Fable Fortunes, which is I'll be probably doing that over the weekend. We are doing the game night again on Sunday.
What game?
We are going to be playing Drawful 2, because it's now released.
I've seen that on Xbox Store.
Yeah, it's now released now, so we're going to be doing that on
that's
Sunday.
Something I won't be there for.
Cool.
Oh, but you love it. You get to draw, and now you've got two colours. And Heavenly's asking, did we watch Money in the Bank?
Yes, I did.
Yes, we did.
Money in the Bank?
Yeah, Money in the Bank.
Deal or no deal?
No, not deal or no deal.
WWE.
Money having in the wank bank.
Yeah, we want to speak to Heavenly and Hanksy about something because we've noticed that they've been watching WWE Network, and we didn't even know that they were fans of wrestling. So
yeah, but these are for the naked men.
You're not watching the same wrestling we're watching, Shimmy.
Sweaty, greased up men touching each other in jock straps.
Yeah, you're definitely not watching the same wrestling we're watching. You're probably watching TNA.
What is the wrestling attire for Triple H? Was he retired now?
At the moment, Triple H wrestling attire is a suit.
What about Sheamus, big ginger one? What does he wear? Underpants and boots. Does he?
And a t-shirt. Sorry. Yeah. Okay.
But you're like, whoa, look at them thigh muscles. I bet he's got a lovely Ekins.
That's what GD thinks about all the time. I wonder what size his Ekins is.
Is it an Ekins or an Arbuck?
Anyway, continue with other stories. Fable Fortune's Kickstarter has been cancelled as developers find outside funding. They are still going to be doing Fable Fortune, but now instead of having to raise it themselves, they've actually got someone who's going to be giving them the money to make it. If you don't know what Fable Fortune is, it's basically Hearthstone within Fable universe. Because everyone's doing a Hearthstone game, aren't they? We've got Fable Fortune.
Skyrim one.
We've got Gwent. What is
it? Elder Scrolls.
We've got an Elder Scrolls one. Give it a chance, we're going to get a Dead Rising one.
I just got some news, actually.
Yeah, go ahead.
No Man's Sky, the developers, they've actually settled for with Sky's secret dispute. Because Sky were actually fighting them because they're using the word Sky.
Really?
Seriously.
What the hell?
I just remembered now.
When I first read that, I saw it and said, oh, No Man's Sky's secret dispute settled. And I thought, Okay, so they might be having an argument with
Sky
someone.
Over the word Sky. They've settled.
Someone really should tell Sky. Oh God, it's like Candy Crush all over again, isn't it? You guys cannot own the word candy. A lot of companies use the word candy.
Hold on. What the fuck
they
was
did
that?
Have that did you remember Beehive Bedlam? That was the best game ever.
No.
Beehive Bedlam was an amazing game on Sky.
Apparently, Sky owned the word Sky.
Oh shit, I feel sorry. I'll read you,
this on bbc.co.uk. It says the maker of the highly anticipated game, No Man's Sky, has revealed a legal challenge has been threatened with the game's name. Sean Murray and his studio have endured years of secret, stupid legal nonsense. That's in quotation marks. After the broadcaster Sky said the game's title infringed on its trademark. We have finally settled with Sky, in brackets, they own the word Sky. We can call our game No Man's Sky, he tweeted. The game is expected to be 2022. Hello Game, blah. Hello Games has not revealed whether it paid Sky to settle the lawsuit.
Sky.
I can't believe that they actually own the word Sky.
It's a trademark, isn't it? Because it's a business.
It's a business.
Business.
I agree. It's a business, and I understand there. But at the same time, it's something you don't really think about. It's thinking.
Yeah, but Sky haven't thought about it, and then they think, well, there could be a popular game here. We could make a few quid off these.
Yeah, I'm not surprised with them.
Like my company use a spray adhesive called from Blue Sky.
Oh fucking hell! Don't
Sky me. Gonna? Is Sky gonna bring the glue company down? I don't think so.
You do not own that word. I own the word. Bad Brian.
Technically, I own that word.
No.
Me and Ryan between us actually own that word. Because we both got the Tower of Blings.
I want to own the at symbol.
GD owns a window that leads to a brick wall.
I'm now owning this. This is mine now. You can't have this.
Backwards.
I own this way too.
See how shiny it is because he's been polishing his hat.
You guys are saying backwards, but I forgot I'm the one who can actually see the stream, so this is the right way according to this. I own this. This is mine now. Yes, you can have Creeper, but I own at. Bring it, Twitter.
Yeah, I think Twitter's going to win that argument.
Yeah. You don't own the word at.
But yeah, it is. I mean, we've had a lot of things. There was Rick King because they wanted to get. Where was it? Was it Saga?
They wanted. Well, they first wanted Candy, and then they wanted Saga, and they were trying to sue Banner Saga because they was afraid that Banner Saga was going to be mixed up with their own brands. Because people are going to mix up a great indie game compared to a match free game. Series.
We were talking earlier about its brand recognition and all that, but if it was just named Sky, then I could understand, but No Man's Sky.
Yeah, the thing
I'd have said, fuck you, I'm calling it No Man's Space, and that would no money off me.
The thing is, there's one thing I'm happy with this, is that Sky actually did keep this, both Sky and No Man's Sky did keep this undercover until it was settled. The thing is, we've had many times this year alone where we've had other ones trying to trademark a certain word, for example, React.
And Let's Play.
And Let's Play that was Sony, which didn't go through.
What was that one with all them YouTubers? What YouTubers? No, I'm thinking of something else, aren't I?
You're thinking React.
Was it React? Is that what
Yeah,
it
because were? They wanted to do that React world, didn't they?
In fact, the whole of Fair Use has been H3 Productions is getting sued, aren't they?
Why are they getting
the
sued?
The Fair Use terms, because they do React videos. And they reacted a guy called Bald Guy. And he's suing them for Fair Use infringement, which they are right doing it, but it's go through court. And everyone's been donating money, people like PewDiePie.
Oh, yeah, I saw that, yeah.
Thousands of pounds and stuff. So they've raised some over £100,000 now, which is going. They don't need that much, but it's going in the kitty now for any other YouTubers that are going to get sued. Mm. It's there to pay for the court fees to prove that fair use it's still a thing, and you can freely use other people's content with it, as long as it's in those guidelines. So.
The thing is, the whole fair use thing is a bit weird, especially when it comes to the YouTuber side of things anyway. But it's like, what we do, we are balancing on the edge of fair use, because technically we're using someone's games to do videos.
Well, yeah, but we're talking about them with their own opinions, aren't we?
Exactly. I think, in the end, I think it's our opinions that people go and see. They're not seeing it to go and watch the actual gameplay.
No.
The thing is, it's like us here at the moment, this is all original. I think the only, well, apart from probably the, now looking at it, the Twitter logo and the Twitch logo and actually the
Gadget's
YouTube
Pringles
side.
And Gadget's Batman and your...
Yeah, and...
Power Rangers.
Yeah.
And your Spider-Woman in the background or whatever the hell that is.
That's not Spider-Woman, that's Gang Beast.
Gang Beast, alright, yeah, I can see.
Yeah. Gang Beast is a great indie game, which I'm looking forward to, because they're testing to do online multiplayer with that now.
Yeah.
So I'm looking forward to it. I hope it works, because I do want to play it online. I'm just pointing it out. There's not much game news this week. Most of it happened last week. Sorry?
What are game releases?
That's what we're going to. We're going to the UK charts and the game releases. So... What's up? Nothing. Ryan thought it was Voltron. And Cad just ran out of Pringles.
I do have another tube downstairs, but...
You can't, yeah.
I can.
No. Oh, yeah, one more thing. There's plans for Bayonetta 3 series, creator says.
Oh, wow.
I'm happy. Oh, and also one more thing that we've got to mention beforehand. Steam Summer Sale begins on Thursday the 23rd at 6 p.m. until July the 4th at 6 p.m. So if you're looking for a bargain, you're a PC gamer, there you go. Make your wallets cry. Oh god, it's going to be the time where I remember I spent nearly £100 just one sale at one time because of that. Anyway, UK game chart. So Doom puts an end to Overwatch's 3-week run at the top of the chart, jumping 2 places from number 3 to number 1, with retailer promotions pushing the average price down by £5 to £31.20. Sales of Doom are up 57% on last week, giving Bethesda their first number one since Fallout 4, and developer id Software their first number one since Doom 3 on PC topped the charts in 2004. Overwatch drops to number 2 with sales down by 24%, remaining ahead of Uncharted 4 of Thief's End, which climbs 1 place to number 3. Older titles, FIFA 16 and GTA 5, still prove popular, also rising by 1 place to numbers 4 and 5 respectively. Mirror's Edge Catalyst slips down to from number 2 to number 6, while retailer promotions boost Call of Duty Black Ops 3 back into the top 10, up from number 12 to number 7. As Euro 2016 is now well underway, Konami's updated Pro Evo Soccer 2016 title on PS4 and PS3 enjoys a 24% sales increase, although is a non-mover at number 8. More promotions guide Star Wars Battlefront back into the top 10, up 7 places to number 9. Lego Marvel Avengers rounds off the top 10 at number 10, while MotoGP 16 Valentino Rossi is the only new title to break in the top 40, new at number 19. So that is up 1 to number 5 is Grand Theft Auto 5, up 1 to number 4 is FIFA 16. Up 1 to number 3 is Uncharted 4 of Thief's End. Down 1 to number 2 is Overwatch. And up 2 to number 1 is Doom.
Ooh.
Yes, so Doom is at the top. Golfing, it's going to be there for a while. Now looking at what games are going to be coming out. So, is there any games that you guys are looking forward to? I never actually asked you guys about that from what we saw at E3 coming out this year now.
I think I mentioned mine.
Battlefield 1.
There's a few interesting, but I think the ones I'm looking forward to most. I mean, that one's coming to preview program. We Happy Few. I'm really intrigued about that one.
Yeah, that will come at the end of next month.
End of July, yeah.
Yeah.
Other than that, Mm. But if I can't remember any games that caught my eye, it obviously didn't catch my eye.
What about you guys in chat? Oh, yeah, there you go. Ryan's already mentioned it, the pirate game.
Yeah, Sea of Thieves, I forgot about that.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to that. They haven't actually given us a release date for that yet, have they? I'm looking forward as well, like you said, to We Happy Few coming out on Early Access next month. No Man's Sky I'm interested in as well.
Yeah, but that wasn't short at E3 at all. It wasn't. But, yeah,
but that is a game that's coming out in this year that I'm looking forward to.
I mean, Battlefield 1's got its place in my game collection, future place.
With me, it's Titanfall 2 out of those three games. Still, the thing is, I'm looking forward to I actually enjoyed the first one. I think the only thing that let me down a bit was that it was all online multiplayer. And I do like, that's what the one thing that I've been wanting is a single player added to it. And that's what they've done for it this time. And I'm happy that they are doing that. And I think a lot of people are happy that they're doing that. Orion says he's obviously, it's year two of LEGO Dimensions. Yeah, we've seen how much you've played that game, mate. I'm not really surprised about that.
PS4 and Xbox One versions of Marvel Ultimate Alliance games may be coming.
Really?
I'd be interested in watching them again. Play them again. Mm. I've actually still got the 360 versions, but...
What about you, Shimmy? Is there any games that you're looking forward to coming out this year? Apart from Battlefield 1?
I've actually sat down and thought about it and what I want to get. I'm happy just playing with what I want to at the moment, so I don't really think I'll be getting any games.
Yeah, Ryan just
Civ 4.
Oh, Civ 6.
Civ 6, sorry, yeah. Just for Ryan.
Dead Rising 4. That's another one, yeah. There's actually, the thing is, that's what I liked about E3. There was plenty of games that were announced coming at the end of the year, which I am looking forward to. That is what we usually get from these press conferences. The games that are basically going to ruin our wallets just before Christmas starts.
To be honest, the way it's going at the moment, my wallet's not going to be hit that hard. There's not that many games coming out end of this year, which I'm interested in.
Yeah. I don't know. I'm still looking forward to seeing. There is a couple of games that I've been wanting. And it's like also Rise of Tomb Raider comes out on the PS4 at the end of the year as well. That I have been waiting for. The thing is, I've refused to buy it on the Xbox One for the fact that it was timed exclusive on there. So I might be picking that up and see what that's like, because it'll probably be a Game of the Year edition of it.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, I'll see how it goes with that. Turtle says Gears War.
Gears of War 4, yeah, that... I'm not excited about that. I'll probably get it, but...
I've never been a huge fan of the Gears series myself.
I think we should do the trilogy then. I think we should do the 4.
Oh, don't make me do the trilogy. I'm happy doing the Halo stuff, because I'm a fan of the Halo series.
I'm sorry, but you owe me.
You. Yeah, good point. Yes, okay, we'll make sure that we do Gears. We'll do Halo Reach, and then the next series will be one of the Gears games. Is that right?
It'll have to be, won't it?
It will have to be, yes, because we usually have a break between Halo games and...
According to Ryan, the new Tomb Raider is poop.
Is it? Sweet. But you can make snow angels! Anyway, let's just do the game release.
Snow Ekins,
yeah. Let's do the game releases of the week. So we'll start with what came out on Tuesday, the 21st of June. Umbrella Corps is available on the Xbox One and PS4 digital only. So who wants to play Battlefield with a Resident Evil skin? Yay. Games coming out on Friday the 24th of June. We have Dino Dini's Kick-Off Revival on the PS4. Okay. Mighty No. 9 comes out on the 360, PS3, Wii U, Xbox One, PS4 and PC. Tokyo Mirage... It's already out in America. So it's going to be out, yeah, on Friday for us. Tokyo Mirage Sessions #FE comes out on the Wii U. Actually, I do want to pick up that because it's supposed to be with Fire Emblem. Mario and Sonic at the Rio 2016 Olympic Games comes out on the Wii U as well. See a lot of Wii U love here. Odin Sphere, oh, fucking hell. Lee First Hire.
Butchering the name again.
Fucking hell. Odin Sphere something comes out on the PS3.
Something.
I'm going with something.
You couldn't actually say.
I can't say. All right, okay. I'll spell it out for you, and you guys try and pronounce it. So it's spelled LeiFHRASIR.
LeiFHRASIR.
Fuck.
Break it down. LeiFHRASIR.
Okay. Odin Sphere, LeiFHRASIR. Fuck off. Comes out on the PS3, PS4, and PS Vita. Rocket League's Collector's Edition comes out on the Xbox One and PS4. Super Meat Boy comes out on the PS4. And Ollie Ollie Epic Combo Edition comes out on the PS4. And then on Tuesday, 28th of June, we've got LEGO Star Wars The Force Awakens coming out on everything.
So that's another Star Wars game.
Yeah. The Technomancer comes out on the Xbox One, PS4, and PC. And Resident Evil 5 comes out on the Xbox One and PS4 digital only. So that is all the games that are coming. On Wednesday the 29th of June, Inside comes out on the Xbox One. Isn't that the...
That's the one...
Limbo
is that the
game,
one
isn't it?
Limbo Lights, where you're like looking through a window at somebody. Yeah. You can see like the walk through a door. Yeah. I'm not sure.
Yeah. That's probably a game I might pick up then, because I'll give it. That looks like a really good game, what we've seen of it.
Oh, actually, thinking about them games that you were saying I'm looking forward to.
Yeah.
It's not a game that was announced, I don't think. XCOM 2, because I've been playing the first XCOM on the
Battle yeah, it's coming out on consoles, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I've been playing it for the first XCOM, and I'm actually gutted I missed it first time around. I'm actually happy that the brought it backwards compatible.
Yeah, well, when is it actually coming out on consoles? I can see on here actually. Yeah, XCOM 2 comes out on Xbox One and PS4 on the 9th of September, according to this.
Yeah, so.
So, well, it's already out on PC, isn't it?
Yeah.
Is it? Yeah,
originally.
Yeah, I think they said that they had to tweak it to get it ready for consoles, but they were planning to come out on consoles anyway. But unfortunately, because they wanted the game out for PC first, because it was originally a PC game.
Yeah. It's quite good, actually. It's impressive.
I think a lot of people like it, because I haven't played the XCOM that we got free with Games with Gold this month yet.
I have. That's what I've been playing.
It's a backwards compatible one, isn't it?
It is.
Yeah. Can you name your characters in it?
Yeah.
You can edit them, yes. You can have where they come from, the name, the nickname.
Cage, I can see a series for you.
Why me?
We'd make a team in CTG.
I'm sorry, don't you remember how shite my internet is when I did my Mass Effect?
Shimmy, I could see a series for you.
Yeah, I could do it.
Brian, I could see a series for you. Someone do it.
Why don't you do it?
Because I've already got enough that I'm doing at the moment.
What so have I, but I can't do any of mine.
Yeah, I know.
Because my internet can't handle the fucking pressure because it's shit. I need to find a new hamster to fucking spin the wheel.
Yay! Oh, yeah, actually, there's one game I forgot to mention, which I'm looking forward to. Two games that are coming out this year that I forgot to mention that I'm looking forward to. Pokemon Sun and Moon, which comes out on...
And Dead or Alive Extreme 2, or whatever the fuck it is now.
No, South Park The Fractured Butthole. The Fractured Butthole.
That looks like a crazy. It's a Stick of Truth, isn't it?
It's basically it follows on straight after the Stick of Truth. What we've seen, because I think your character comes down pretending to be the king or something. Still, after the end of it.
Yeah, they said it's like the kids have moved on from playing fantasy and they're playing superheroes.
Yeah.
And you have to start from the bottom again.
Yep. So I'm looking forward to it. But yeah, I think that is pretty much for this week. Shimmy, Cajr, thank you for joining me.
Yes.
Thank you, chat, for joining us as well. Ryan, what's he talking about? I might end up like the Snow Angels, like on Tomb Raider. Yes, yes, you will. guys, thank you for joining us as well. I forgot the other little bit. You can follow me on Twitter at GDW2007. You can follow Shimmy on Twitter at Red Shimmy. You can follow Cajr on Twitter at CAJR87. Any streams planned, guys, before we move away?
Nope. Well, yeah, enjoy.
Oh, yeah, we're doing the Halo thing, yeah. Sorry?
Hopefully.
Shimmy? Hopefully.
Well, I found the time, actually, to actually sit down and effort into it and just not stand there, sit there quiet. And...
Well, if you
have some recorded footage, though, that I need to sort out for you.
Cool. Shimmy is streaming, you can find him at twitch.tv/redshimmy. When Cajr, hopefully one day your internet will come back to life, mate.
I'm trying to get past this, my dad to... Get a new internet provider.
Yeah, that's cool. When Cajr hopefully will be back streaming again, you can find him at twitch.tv/CAJR87. For me, we have got a couple of plans that are coming up. We've got on the Thursday Halo Reach with me and Cajr again. We've got Resident Evil 7 demo that I'll be playing through. Yeah, I've actually put myself for that one. We've got Fable Fortune Alpha. We've also got... Hopefully we'll be doing some Super Fight if we can get someone else to join us, Shimmy, soon. Because the beta is back up again for that. And also this Sunday, which is Sunday the 26th of June, we will be doing a CTG game night again. This time we are going to be doing Drug War 2. No, it's actually out. So catch us for that. It will be on my Twitch channel, which is twitch.tv/GDW2007. Usually most of the streams start around about 9 p.m. Also, you can follow Crave Your Game on Twitter, at Crave Your Game. You can follow... us here on Twitch. We do the podcast every Wednesday, usually starting around 9 p.m. UK time. Go twitch.tv/CTG podcast, or you can watch us on YouTube as well, which is youtube.com/CraveYourGames, where, for example, we put our video out once a day, every day. And one that you can go and view right now is The Division, which came out on Monday, where we go and battle in the park. So that's fun to watch. Also watch Quiplash. That's a fun one.
Quiplash is a good one.
Quiplash is fun. For the audio version of the podcast and the updates, you can find those at craveyourgame.wordpress.com. And if you're 18 and over and you want to join a friendly gaming community, you can do so by going to cravethegame.net. That is everything, I think. Did I miss anything out?
Nope.
No?
I don't think so, Spartan.
Yep. So thank you guys for joining us. We will be back next week for episode 100 of the CTG podcast.
The original crew together.
I feel really old. So, join us next week for that. Until then, thank you. I'm moving a little bit further here. Thank you, and goodbye, everybody. See ya.
Goodbye.
Bye-bye.
The worst bit I hate of the Xbox conference is always the ID Xbox section. Because it's just they're just showing you name after name. I feel like trying to write fucking name.
Yeah, you right.
I've got Cuphead, which...
I want that to just come out. Just give us a goddamn date for that. We've seen Cuphead.
This is the other one that you want to see, GD. Outlast 2.
No, I don't. Let that be delayed.
I think it was called Deliver to the Moon.
Yeah, isn't that like a...
Slime something.
Oh, slime branches.
That's one.